see it. Just kind of hold the sword up like
the sword.
The knife. So hold it up like this. Hold it up like that.
Wait, where's the bottle?
Hold it.
They didn't keep it.
Hold it up just like that. Just
can you guys
like
slide
that.
Just a little bit?
Just turn it, turn it, turn it.
Yeah, that's right, that's right, that's right.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Bellagio. I'm Randy Morton, the president and CEO of Bellagio, and I am honored on all 8,200 employees here at Bellagio are honored to welcome you here today. Now, there's going to be a martini coming down Las Vegas Boulevard any second, so please get out of the way for the mayor's martini. Very, very important to get this right. And only at Bellagio will get a martini from the Petrosian Bar.
Is that a gin martini or vodka martini?
You know, after a while, it doesn't matter.
Well, we're trying to get the first one right. How's that? Well, of course, we're here to celebrate the 5th annual Vegas Uncorked by Bon Appetit. And it's a very, very exciting weekend we have planned. And of course, behind us, the iconic Bellagio fountains, which we're going to help kick this off. And this is really an honor for us here at Bellagio to show off again the fountains, and of course, for Las Vegas as a destination to kick off the fountains today. Today we have with us Adam Rappaport here, the editor-in-chief of Bon Appetit. There we go. And to my right, the gentleman without a martini, Mayor Oscar Goodman. And down to my left, the star chef of Bellagio, Mr. Julian Serrano, who's with Picasso. And dangerous, yeah. And to my left, Pamela Drucker Mann, Vice President Publisher of Bon Appetit Magazine. And Kathy Tull, Senior Vice President of Marketing for the LVCVA, is here this afternoon. Now I'd like to turn it over to Pamela.
Do they have a champagne bottle?
Yes, they're not giving it to me yet.
On behalf of Bon Appetit, I would like to personally thank the Bellagio for kicking off the 5th anniversary of Vegas Uncorked by Bon Appetit. I'd also like to thank our extraordinary resort partners, the MGM Grand, Caesar's Palace, the Encore Wynn, and of course, last but certainly not least, Mandalay Bay. I personally want to thank our title sponsor, the LVCVA, and a shout out to Kathy Tull, for without them, this event would not even exist. If last year was any indication of the success of Vegas Uncorked by Bon Appetit, I think we're in good shape. We brought 5,000 food lovers and luxury travelers who spent the weekend eating a lot, shopping, having fun, and I'm personally looking forward to doing that myself, as this is my first time at Vegas Uncorked by Bon Appetit. At this time, I would like to introduce our editor-in-chief, who already got a shout-out, but Adam Rappaport.
Thank you, Pam.
Let's do it.
Thank you very much. Welcome all to Vegas Uncorked by Bon Appetit. This is actually my first kind of technical month on the job, so I'm afraid to admit that I'm a Vegas Uncorked virgin. And I'm looking forward to this weekend. I got off the plane, I see these big billboards with all these chefs, and I'm like, oh, wait a minute, these are the guys that are staying right here, right now. So it's incredible to get all you guys together. Thank you so much for contributing. It's gonna be a blast these next several days. I plan to get really full and maybe a little bit drunk. And I'm gonna throw it to Mayor Goodman. Here you go, Mayor.
Thank you very much. As you know, I am the happiest mayor in the universe, and there's a reason for it. Can you imagine being the mayor of a community that has the greatest hotel casinos, the greatest cuisine in the world, the best entertainment, the best retail boutique shopping? It gets no better than that, except when Bon Appetit comes here with Vegas Uncorked. This is remarkable. You look around here, there's so much talent, the greatest chefs in the world coming to Las Vegas, many of them making this their home. But the one thing that we have for sure is that... Was that a practice, Julian? I know that wasn't the real McCoy, was it? I don't know. That's what's, you know, the chefs became celebrities. That's the problem.
Careful, he's got a knife.
No, there was a time that they stayed in the kitchen, okay? And now they're out there and they think that they're movie stars. Pulling on, you should be ashamed of yourself. Okay, that's good. That was a practice round. It just shows you what counts. Here they bring you your champagne, and I haven't a drink in sight. This is a very disturbing thing. But you're about to experience one of the great wonders of the world at the Bellagio, this magnificent resort. And we're going to do something very, very special. And if I don't get the signal soon, I'm going to be in a lot of trouble because you said I had a minute to go, and that's 5 minutes ago. But that's okay. Something good is going to happen here. Just look around. Look at your favorite chef. And we're about to have a countdown, everybody. No, we're not. This is unbelievable. This is the first time that Bellagio has let me down. I have lived in this community for years. Five, four, three. No. Wait a second. Marshall, take that woman away. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Wow!
Wow! Woo!
Last year it was in such a small room, there's no way you could get everybody.
I took a shot at like five people and actually got them.
Let's have a toast out there!
Just don't watch the face!
Yeah.